Let us now discover the capabilities of list controls through this demonstration. The first control that we study under the list category is OE combo, and you could see that it is used to set display attribute into drop down and value attribute into a model. So this is a regular use case. So you could give a label here, and then you could give a star here which says that it is required, and then as a result of that you will be able to display this list of values here. So the configuration that should be done is actually over here. So you will use a template here which is a DOM bind. That is because you are trying to use this without actually trying to create a polymer element here. And in this you have the label which is country over here, and then you have validations which are required here, and also the list of the values. The list data will contain the list of the values that should be displayed as part of the drop down box. So these are the three minimalistic things that you will have to do in order to do that. It is also possible to configure a pre-selected value. You could do the code for this from here, and you have you could use a multi-select to choose the multiple options. That option is available here. So you will have to choose this multi over here, which is an attribute that you will have to be giving here, and multi with selected preset value. This is again one more variant which is possible with this, and you could also allow the free text just in case you are not having a country name which is available here. You could type that over here, and then that value will be taken as its selection. One more interesting list control is a radio group. You could see that you could set up the radio buttons in order to make a choice, and you could also enable and disable the radio groups here. So the way to do that is you need to use this OE-radio-group element here, and with this you could do the data binding, and then you could set all these classes and enable, disable. That code is available here, and also you will use the same array which is the list data, and in order to configure this values here. And you could have preset values. You could see that the oranges is highlighted here. And you could have object as list data, so which is the properties will be taken for them. The code is available here. And you could also style the radio buttons. For example, if I click this, the styling should change. So you could use this with a set of styling elements which is over here, and with a custom style you will be able to achieve this objective also. So these are the various possibilities with the radio group.